Robertson, here. Mr. Lang.
Yes.
Mrs. Moore.
Here.
Mr. Nelson.
Here.
Mr. Ryan.
Here.
Okay, citizen participation, do you have anybody?
I have no cards.
Any agenda adjustments?
I have the presentation, we will not be with, for this meeting, gonna be, they're coming.
The 22nd, May 22nd.
Remove 17-05 then. Any other agenda adjustments?
I have a question with the personnel committee meeting. Since Mr. Allen is not present, I was wondering if we could either make an adjustment or ask to remove the number one on the list. Is that all we can hear from the committee? And have some discussion about the non-working contracts.
You'd like to move the agenda so that we're passing out of B, C, and D?
Hold on.
Can you do a pen or point of order?
Sure.
Sorry about that, I was trying to get a point of order here. Okay, so Mr. Ryan, you're asking that the non-unit contracts be again tabled?
Yes.
Defer to personnel committee again would be the proper motion. Are you deferring them back to personnel?
That would be sufficient.
Okay, there's a motion on the floor to support.
Support.
Any discussion? I would ask if this has something to do with, I don't know where this communication may come from, but only one committee member at that meeting, is what I'm seeing here. Is there miscommunication on date and time?
I think there was, and we kind of got that cleared up now on all the committee meetings. We'll send an email out to all committee members.
Okay, so is that part of the reasoning here? Is that the real reason?
Well, there's also a level of concern that we're putting a non-unit employee under a dated contract versus a working unit.
Okay.
So
Mr. Dempsey, the chair, aware of that concern?
He is very aware of that concern.
Apparently it did not come up at the meeting.
We actually did discuss it on a meeting back in January or February that I sat in on with Carol and Dempsey.
Now, I'm going to mention, we'll talk about it.
So if this motion passes, I would ask that committee members do our best to make sure it doesn't take the time. Okay, any other discussion? I hope we can get this resolved. This is the third time that it will be a personnel. And I realize that there was some confusion. We do need to bring this to a conclusion. Any other discussion?
Do you repeat the motion?
Any other discussion? Hearing none, Robin, please.
Mr. Lang?
Yes.
Mrs. Morris?
Yes.
Mr. Ryan?
Yes.
Mrs. Albertson?
Yes.
And Mr. Dempsey?
Yes. Any other agenda adjustments? I would like to request that we add discussion on the sinking fund to the note.
Which item is that, sir?
Okay.
Robin, I have the board election discussion. I think that's Kathy Stewart.
Oh, okay. I'm making a motion that we add agenda item sinking fund renewal discussion.
After the ISP board election.
Where do you think that best fits? Mrs. Ford?
Ford.
Any other discussion?
The ISP board election is here.
Oh, Mrs. Morris?
Yes.
Mr. Nelson?
Yes.
Mr. Ryan?
Yes.
Mrs. Albertson?
Yes.
And Mr. Lang?
Yes.
I don't know what that means.
It would be like 9A.
Okay, go ahead.
Oh, ISP board election discussion. Kathy Stewart came up to the board and let's see if you have some.
You have a memo?
Yeah, we have a memo from the ISP.
Okay.
She doesn't.
Okay.
Okay, any other agenda adjustments? All right, hearing none, we'll move on to buildings and grounds and finance committee report.
First of all, I guess I need to apologize to Jeff Ladd for not having this at the last meeting and everybody else who was here because this kind of slipped through the cracks with everything else that was going on in the last meeting. We were supposed to be discussing bus renewals 2 weeks ago when we discussed the higher important bottom line. So, Jeff, I apologize if you got to the side. Having said that, we met on April 13th at 4 o'clock. Myself, Pat Nelson, Bob Lang, Pete Pacelli, Jeff Ladd, Carol Selby, Regina, and Melissa were in attendance. Pete and Melissa discussed the debt elimination plan updates, discussed the revised budget and how the election, upcoming election at that time, could hinge on the budget and the debt plan, and also the upcoming BEA discussion could possibly hinge on that as well. I think it was a good conversation by all that we were able to schedule a meeting with the BEA. We met the night before the last board meeting with them. We talked about some general fund budget updates. Again, with the teachers getting their 3% raise, we talked about some other things to work on with the BEA. And again, we met with the BEA, and I think it was a well-receptive meeting on all parties. We also talked about district advertising with the WNEM package. Pete and Carol were discussing the 2017-18 package. I think we decided to do some more research before we made this decision to bring that to the board. We talked about Chartwell's contract, which also we neglected, and I apologize for that one as well. That was supposed to be on the agenda at the last meeting as well, but I heard agenda, I told it confused. So I apologize for that, but that's also a extension for their four-year contract to renew the third or four-year contract. We talked about the bus leases. We have six buses up for lease that would expire. We need to replace them. Jeff went into a lengthy discussion about the testing of gas engine buses versus diesel. It sounds like it's going to be a win for everyone to give the gas engines a try. So we need to make a recommendation to approve the new bus leases as well. We talked about some custodial and maintenance issues. Jeff just went over a quick update of district-wide maintenance and updates, and we were hoping that the sinking fund would pass and it could cover some very needed maintenance throughout the district. Unfortunately, that didn't happen, so back to the grind on that. We also talked about the GSRP contract, and I believe Carol and Regina did a great job of explaining to us again what that contract is for, and did a good job with delivering a stipend contract package. And then we went over the organizational chart, and Carol presented a start of an organizational chart. I think it was a good start, but it needed some work, and I think Pat made a recommendation that he would work with Carol to get that put into another program that is more user friendly. So that's building grounds for when we get both our team. To make a motion from the Building and Grounds Finance Committee meeting to approve the six added buses and the Chartwell contract. I'm not sure if we need to do those separate, Robin, or if we can do them together.
So the minutes will reflect that the motion included the buses to the Chartwell contract.
So I'm making a motion to approve the new bus lease and extend Chartwell's contract for the third or the fourth year.
Second.
Mr. Rhines?
Yes.
Mrs. Albertson?
Yes.
Mr. Lenny?
Hold on.
I'm sorry.
Any discussion on that? Hold on. Put attention as well. No. Just got to keep you on my toes on all things.
Let's see. Mr. Lang?
Yes.
This is Morris and Mr. Mills.
Yes.
Can I make a comment?
Certainly you can.
I guess I'd just like to thank the Chartwell folks for showing up. You do a nice job for our students. We appreciate what you do every day. Thank you. You have to do a nice job to move these buses.
Speaking of Chartwell, a special thank you, just in case you guys leave, for helping out with the teacher appreciation red carpet luncheons that we had this week. The teachers much appreciated from the comments that I got. And Chartwell's, even though they didn't cook the food, but they ordered the cakes and make the punch was awesome. Awesome punch. And they especially appreciated that it was very low in sugar. That was a good thing.
Thank you.
It's
my pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Okay, moving on with the personnel committee. Mr. Allen isn't here, so Ms. Allen, would you present that report?
So we talked about those four items. The non-union contracts were reviewed, and I guess that's off the table right now. the vetting process for recognition of awards and naming of facilities. And Dempsey thought it would be best if we have a committee that would look at the criteria for naming or recognizing individuals. And these are just some thoughts, not anything concrete, but we talked about categories, service, arts, athletic, and then community members who donated money to the district. And we talked about in terms of the Wall of Fame here at the high school and any other recognitions that we do to make sure that we have some real clear criteria before we start naming baseball fields or anything else. And I think this has come up way before my time, and it's not been done, or it's been some hesitation, so we just have to, if it's your pleasure to revisit, that has some clear categories on which you will be recognizing people for. Item C, need to hire a math teacher for the high school, where Mr. Kemp right now is teaching Project Lead the Way and math, but we'll need him to teach full-time Project Lead the Way next year, because we're going to have two sections, section one and the first year and the second year, and that will mean that we will need a full-time math teacher. And item D, public employees who have criminal convictions discussion. We currently have an employee on leave, so he's not working in the district, but he's now met the criteria for termination because of a criminal conviction. So we take recommendation number one off the table, where the personnel committee is recommending postponing the naming of the baseball field, approving the hiring of the high school math teacher for next year, and the termination of the staff as per PA 131. Three recommendations.
Is there a motion?
Do we need a motion, or is that the recommendation of the committee? Okay.
To approve the first
one. Support.
You guys are all in the same. Motion of support to accept the recommendations, recommendation 2, 3, and 4 on the personnel committee. Any discussion?
Carol, with the second, what was the second motion?
Oh, the second one is the postponement of the name of the baseball field. And actually, that was combined with putting a committee together to come up with criteria for naming anything in the district.
You had a comment about the you said something about recognizing people. Mm-hmm. And I wasn't at that time, I should have been, but somehow I missed knowing what was happening. But I'm concerned about recognizing people, because at our last meeting, came up that we're not doing that as we've been doing it before. And from my committee, the curriculum committee, I am wondering if that would be also proper if the committee could recognize a teacher that has shown to be outstanding as far as developing the curriculum, enhancing curriculum, showing teacher efficacy in their actions. Just from a curriculum standpoint, how would that not be?
I'm not sure that fits into this
discussion. The discussion is the Wall of Fame.
Yes, Wall of Fame.
Mm-hmm. I just wasn't sure where it fit in, so.
Well, from a big picture standpoint, we really need to start having criteria for anything, whether it be teacher recognition or whatever, that we have an appropriate vetting process. that we had the last month, right?
There is policy about recognition of staff.
So we just need to follow?
Yes, we do.
That would be helpful.
Okay, so back to our policy book. So we should review that in a committee. So you're talking about curriculum, so curriculum.
Any other discussion? Can you hear me, Robin?
Mrs. Albertson?
Yes.
Mr. Lang?
Yes.
Mrs. Morris?
Yes.
Mr. Ryan?
Yes.
And Mr. Nelson?
Yes. Next, we have the consent agenda. We have the April 2017 check register, April 2017 board report, minutes from the Monday, April 10th, 2017 business meeting, and Monday, April 24th, 2017 committee of the whole meeting.
Will we accept the consent agenda?
Motion or support?
Support.
Any discussion? Okay, very good. Now we'll roll call this.
Mr. Lang?
Yes.
Mrs. Morris?
Yes.
Mr. Nelson?
Yes.
Mr. Ryan?
Yes.
And Mrs. Albertson?
Yes.
The next item is the ISD board election discussion. Did anybody pick their memo? Just something to guys here. Carol, do you want to brief us on this?
And I will, it's been a while since I read this, so I'll have to just kind of read through it real quick. We have to designate a representative, Robin, correct me if I'm wrong, to support the ISD board. Each constituent designates his representative to the electoral body. A resolution adopted within 21 days of the date of the election.
Well, at this point in time, we don't even know who the candidates are, so we might be able to designate somebody who's functional on our behalf, but wouldn't be able to designate who we want them to vote for, so we need to probably take this up on the 22nd.
Well, you have to, one meeting prior to, so this is just our open meeting,
okay,
saying that we discussed it. All we have to do today is just to say we've discussed it, and then the candidates, the information will come forward. That's when you designate someone to represent your district and an alternate, and then candidates. But as the memo states, you have to have one meeting prior to making those designations. So this is our one meeting, or we could have called a special on the 22nd, just to do that.
One meeting is needed to consider the appointment and the enclosed resolution, and the second meeting to adopt and approve the resolution. Meetings can be held on the same day, just doesn't affect you.
Fine tomorrow.
So
it needs to be on the agenda for the 22nd.
It will be on the agenda for the 22nd for you to designate your representative and your alternate, and then your candidates that you're supporting. But today you're just considering it. Everyone got a copy of the resolution and copy the memo, so you can say you discussed it in open one meeting prior to. So that's the only purpose today, just a discussion item.
Any questions about this? This is an annual, whenever they have their elections, whether they have them every year or not.
There's 4-year terms, 2-year terms?
6 years.
6 years.
6-year terms.
Yeah. I think every 2 years.
So we'll choose which Saginaw County Indiana School District person we'd like to see on the board of persons. And our delegate will vote for us, the board choose. So that's what the decision is.
And I don't know if the election is during the day or...
I think I went last year.
I think you did.
I think you did.
I think, yeah. And I quite honestly don't remember when the election... And did you have to go in and vote?
No.
other questions or discussion? Okay, moving on, number 9A, the sinking fund discussion. I wanted to see on the agenda because we just nearly missed getting that passed, and talking to members of the public, we certainly have a good idea why. There was some confusion because the way that we were legally required to show it on the ballot did not allow us to identify that the three mills was actually replacing the existing six mills. A lot of people saw it and thought it was being taxed on top of the six mills already paying. That was a little problematic for us, so we needed to be more aggressive and talk to people. From experience in looking at villages from the 90s, or the last school bond, and really important that we get in front of people so that we can answer those questions and explain it. I found in the past that when you can talk to somebody face to face on their doorstep, they're pretty comfortable. And they want to know the facts, especially for those individuals that vote regularly. And so I think we need to take another run at this. We'll have to decide relatively quickly, whether that's August or November. I would suggest we have whomever it is, a task force that talks, that puts together the game plan for what we want to do, and how we're going to get volunteers to get out and talk face to face with people. I'm confident we can get this done. I just think that there was some confusion. There's also confusion because it was on the same ballot with the 18 mill renewal, and people just didn't quite understand it. And as you know, you can only put certain language on the ballot, so we can't clarify on the ballot what's going on. And, now, unfortunately, this was something else on the ballot. We're going to have to foot the bill for that election. So, I'd like to hear from the board members how they feel. I'd like to hear from Bill how she feels about it, Pete, and everybody else.
And what exactly was done prior to this election?
There was some phone calling done. There was some face-to-face. I had a couple of public opportunities to talk to quite a few people. Some people understood it. Certainly the 18 mill was clearly understood and passed without the tax bill. But a lot of people did not understand that the 3 mill sinking fund was actually going to replace the current 6 mill. I don't know how many people were actually called, how many people were actually spoken to versus just calling.
We, Pete and Dempsey and I called for 2 hours on the Monday prior to, and I know that the BDA and the teachers call their parents. I noticed we lost by 100, a little less than 100.
So 38.
For the sinking fund?
38.
Go ahead.
38.
So in looking at the voter registration list, most of our registered voters are seniors. Mm-hmm. Very few young voters. So I think we need to reach out to our resident parents who are not registered. And even though we had voter registration apps at all the buildings with the big display that said vote, register, we need to be more diligent in reaching out to our resident parents who are not registered.
The way we do that, by the way, is you have to go door to door. You have to knock on the door and talk to them.
Give them an app.
Well, or you give them the information that they need,
so
they can make an educated decision. People are very receptive in this community to a face-to-face dialogue. So you're right. A lot of our registered voters were not on those lists that were called. The other thing that we have is we have a very high number of absentee voters in Bridgeport Township.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
People that just don't want to leave their home to vote, they a high level. So those absentee ballots go out early, and we have to get information out, because I talked to some people that said, no, I voted no for that because it was additional tax, and I paid the register in fact, and they said, well, I already voted.
And
I think I
did.
I already voted.
We experienced that when we called.
Yes.
I experienced that going door to door.
So if we're going to take another run at this, whatever our game plan is, we have to make sure we have all of that in order to do that.
And for this election, we used a lot of technology, and I think my thinking is for the voters that we're talking about targeting, they're not necessarily using technology. Because we did School Messenger, we did Facebook, it's on a web page. But I think Pat is right. For the voters that we're really targeting, it's going to have to be face-to-face.
And it's going to have to be early.
And it's going to have to be early to catch those that do ask you that.
Pat is ringing.
It's really essential that we share with our public what it is these funds are going to be used for. To just ask people to give us 3% of their replacement for 6 and not understand what the money's going to be used for, that's a pretty tough sell. And we need to talk about the physical plant issues that we would address, technology issues that we would address, but this is not for, you know, wages and benefits for teachers and things like that. Is it, unless we educate them as to what this is for, it's going to be a tough sell.
And we have the video, but again, the video, that's technology, and so if they didn't.
One big sheet with a graph or some kind of graphic. Because even this is too much to read.
We did have one.
Yeah, we did.
We could do it differently, because this time we can just focus on the one. Because we had 0 for the non-homestead, it really was a lot, so we focused on 1-3% cut, or 3-mill cut. But I would say too, just under, I was out handing out the flyers on election day, and it was a very low turnout, which I think hurt us. We need to have all hands on deck for this next one. I think a higher turnout in November, for example, because August you're going to get people who are not paying attention. We're going to need time and have a whole campaign on hand to do that. So we can talk about the committee, but for August, we probably, I've talked to a few people, August is not a great time to serve.
I would argue though that our issue came with the absentee voters.
Yeah, because we need.
I can almost guarantee you that's where it was lost,
right?
The absentee voters. And a lot of people have no clue what a sinking fund was. No idea, what does that mean? I can't even remember when being voted on in Bridgeport, that's why I'm there 25 years. So what is a sinking fund? What does that mean? So to Bob's point, yeah, this is what a sinking fund is and this is what it does.
We've never had a sinking fund.
Yeah, no. So they have to do a better job of getting the voters.
Right.
And getting to those absentee voters, because I assure you, most likely will be.
I just think having a visual of what we're going to get, because we were showing all things were wrong in the video, I think you can show what we can accomplish, like a rendering of something that's new that people can point to versus what's wrong.
Yeah, so whether it's August or whether it's November, I believe that we'll get the support we need. But I can also tell you, in this community, if you will, that if we don't renew this year, and the 6 mills goes away, yeah, we will have a huge challenge getting them, getting it back. Okay, so whether it's August or November, we really need to put a game plan together and make it happen. It's going to be very difficult.
We won by 4.
Pardon me?
We won by 4 votes. The last bond issue, the one that just expired.
Really? 4
votes? We only won by 4. And someone was
going to
challenge the 4.
I didn't
realize
that.
We only won by 4.
Any other discussion on that?
No. I agree with everything that you said, because my experience going, because after we left Atkins, I said I was going door to door, and I did get it out of there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I think there was, like you just said, a misunderstanding of the same.
We couldn't call it a renewal, unfortunately, but it was a renewal at a lower rate, but we couldn't say that in a legal language.
But the other sad thing I thought, and I don't know how we're going to bridge this gap, but the meeting we had for parents at Atkins, no one showed up. Yeah, how can that be? And I don't think he was a parent.
I
said he was a regular.
I can tell you that I've been through
personally. No parent showed. Why aren't we communicating with, that's our base.
But if they're not registered voters, that meeting was for the voters.
I don't think that's why they weren't there. I think we're missing a communication piece.
No, we're not. I'll tell you what. When we did the two separate millages that failed, and went back for the special assessment. And one millage, I held 21 public forums. 21, and we had a total of 180 people across 21 public forums. The next time around, I only did 6. I did 5 churches, the township office, and I had a total of 30 people.
For 6?
Yes. There were people not come out for those. We're not going to get, we had one in the church, nobody showed up other than the person that locked the door. John Grimes was at the one out of the something, how many people were there? Maybe 10? Is that 10 or 10?
And the teachers are calling their students.
We did them during the day, we did them in the evening, we did them at all these locations, making it as flexible as we could, and that's all we got. It just, public forums really don't work well. But what people do appreciate, even people that have decided to vote no, will appreciate you knocking on the door and just having the courtesy to speak to them face to face. Now, for some, that's so they can tell you to go away and vote no. But we had great success when we did that. We went some evening, most of those weekends, and on Saturdays.
Well, I agree we should do that.
Any other discussion? Pete, I have a question for you when you say November versus August, because we have a short timeline of making this decision, correct?
Yeah, would that be my next Monday? Then we'd have to pay the election costs, so I mean, if you want to do it twice, we double up on it. But again, the people I've talked to, you need to give one good shot and have all hands on deck, so that's why we need, my recommendation, we need to turn November, especially with the teachers back. And we can start September going door to door before the absentees go out. Just take one time to do all that, so.
Any objection to choosing November versus August?
We then work football games.
Yeah.
Right on, take a lot of parents for football games. I was thinking we could leverage Bridge Festival a bit if it's all in August, but.
Still good?
Yeah.
Good word out.
Okay, any other discussion on that topic? Okay, board and superintendent comments.
Again, thanks, Charbel, you guys did a fabulous job, and again, I apologize that we skipped you last 2 weeks ago, and Jeff, thanks again. I think we're really needing a sinking fund out from your department. There's one thing that's kind of weighing on me a little bit. I got a phone call from Pat last week and said he wanted me to get with Jeff to again go look at the Schraub building. I went over there the other day and it's borderline inhabitable. It's in disarray. You can smell the mold and mildew outside the front door.
This is the one that had blood for the basement floor.
Yeah, the basement's dried out. I didn't see any signs of water other than there is still some rough leaks. There's a lot of mud and debris down there that obviously backed up through the rains. There's a definite water line at about 2 foot, 2.5 foot. You can see where the water was in there, so it had been there for a while. We're going to need to do something with that building. Figure something out because that building is going to end up falling in if we're not careful.
What's that cost like, Jeff?
What's that?
What was the cost?
Years ago, it was about $275.
That's a lot.
I'm going to
take it out because
asbestos,
you
have
a lot.
And that's where the
thought of being. There's definitely that basement is full of asbestos pipe. There's thousands of footage.
At some point, we're going to have to deal with it.
And it's getting worse and worse as it sets. Our water is still coming in. All the drains are still leaking through the roof when I was there. So my recommendation is to shut that down for public use period. The liability for the district is, there's some huge liability. Somebody goes in there and gets sick from what's going on in that building. So I know the gymnasium is being used for Bridge Fest. I would make the recommendation that we not use
that.
Schluckbier, I didn't go into Schluckbier this time. I was in there a couple months ago, I believe it was 2 or 3 months ago when I went in. truck here wasn't in that bad a condition. I could do another walkthrough to tell you for sure, but I'm not comfortable with the condition of the trucks.
Well, there's a common boiler between the two buildings, so if you take one, you gotta take both.
Sure.
But I mean, using Shaw right now for a public event is, I believe, just opening up a liability for the district that we don't need. Schluckbeer, if they could use that for the haunted house, the haunted school, that's one thing, but having them funnel the public into Shaw in condition, it's in their ceiling tiles that are falling down all over the place, it's in disarray.
Jeff, the roof, the golf roof breaks on that building?
There's at least two leaks. One may not even be a leak, it's just the drain coming off of the scupper. And it's not, it was originally connected back in the day to the sewer instead of the storm. And I'm just pointing out where it's like, you know they want to spend money on the building, so I don't really want a big pipe, like 4-inch, cast iron pipe, so.
That pipe that's leaking is the one that's causing the damage on that end of the building, because that water's coming down that pipe, going under that wall and into that classroom, that's just rotting everything off.
That's the end of flooded back, nice, first year I was here, so it's been 8 or 9 years.
Pretty heavily invisible world inside that room, there's heavy mold inside that.
Actually, during that.
Nope, I'm all set.
Again, I would like to thank the staff from Chuck Wilson for the job. And just glancing through the district updates, I would commend Principal about Principal Baker, who was like, wow, great things are going on at your schools. Continue with that very comprehensive report there. I see Mr. Chapman wasn't here, but I did beat him. Oh, he did. Did he mention to you, there was a class for after-school program people through the state?
A class for after-school program?
Because they're going to be having the money to grant for that.
Oh, that is not a class, but the Center for Success will be starting their after-school program in the fall. Did you talk about something different?
Yeah, I was talking about something different, and he said he's going to check on it. And I don't, it may be past the deadline, but there was, I'm going to say a class for people who work with after-school programs that was from around the state. And he's going to check for it.
Okay.
To see if we would have to pay a fee for this person to go. But it was to just line up with what people are doing around the state. Did I match? Okay. I'll check back. It was something that was in our email, and I asked him about it at our last meeting, and he said he was going to check on it. I'll find it. I'll check with him tomorrow.
Yeah, thank you. I had the opportunity to attend the last band concert of the year. That was a pleasant experience. Got to listen to the students of our music.
Okay, thank you all as well. We didn't have a chance to attend our awards night last week. It was great. A lot of kids received some nice scholarships, scholarship opportunities. Some very nice young people. So that was a lot of fun. And fundraiser this week. The girls softball team, Mr. Barlow's having an all-you-can-eat fundraiser at Palm Bay from 5 until
8.
If you get a chance, I think they get part of the meal proceeds plus whatever management tip jar. That's what they're going to do here. So if you're hungry, you want to go out and support the softball team, you can have some pizza.
They have one of those pizza.
Thank you.
Chicken wings and all.
Yeah,
and the ladies do the serving too. They, the softball,
yeah.
Team, so that's fine. When you get a chance, please read through the many updates. There are quite a few, lots of information on here, including pictures. We included pictures from the red carpet celebrations that we had. And there's a picture of Mr. Morkel, who was honored, celebrated at the final band concert. And the last picture on your update, so this last two pictures, are of Rihanna Ramsey and Amaya Brewer, they had a signing?
Yeah, they signed a letter of intent to
letter.
Their desired colleges today.
So Coach Seals kind of has started making that a big deal for these kids. Not that this is the first year that kids have signed to go play at a college, but this is the first time we've kind of made it a big deal. We invite the press, and the press does come, not a lot, but press does come, and lots of photo ops and family. And Jen, they set up the auditorium very nicely. So we're very proud of those girls. Today, this afternoon, I was invited to participate in a press conference with Governor Schneider, Superintendent Whitson, and representatives from the SRO, and only two superintendents were there, the East Detroit superintendent and myself. I was there. And 30-minute press conference talking about the partnership agreement, the ins and outs of the partnership agreement. Pretty much the governor and the superintendent Whitson spoke, but we did get some questions about the process, and especially since it was a two-week process of putting it together and then the next steps. So it was a good experience, and I can't tell you what TV stations it's going to be on, but there were about four different cameras that I saw set up there. So that was this afternoon. And the conference was from 3 to 3:30. Did my best to represent the Bridgeport Falls Community Schools. And I'm feeling really positive about the next 3 years with the partnership agreement. I think we're going to see some very good things come out of what's happening at Athens Elementary. And I believe that.
I wanted to also thank the school board for your support for the Martha Morris School Board Scholarship. The young man that was selected, DeTwan Stinson, was an absolutely wonderful person to receive that scholarship. And it just made our family so proud to still be able to have his name on something like that. I put it on my Facebook, and some of our friends are still contributing because they didn't know about that. And so I hope it will be ongoing, that we can kind of match anything that we're following.
That was a great kid to receive that award. And I realized after the assembly, because I've seen him up and down the hallways, and every time I see him, I think, how do I know this kid, other than he's a student here? And then I realized he was one of my elementary babies when I was elementary principal.
Isn't he exceptional?
He is, and he always has been.
Just extraordinary.
So poised.
He is. He came up to me after the whole program and said, "Oh, could I have a picture taken with you?" And he had a person take a picture. And they don't usually do that. they're all polite, but they don't always want that memento of the occasions.
So this is a reminder, because this is the season. The seniors are being recognized. They're having their final concerts, assemblies, whatever. Graduation is Friday, June 1st? Second. 7 o'clock at the Dow Jensen Center. And last year, it was beautiful. It was beautiful. And so I hope we have a healthy presence from the board there.